problem, second problem on design constraint, that is for a balanced rectangular section, B into D of singly reinforced beam determine number one, depth of neutral axis, second one, moment of resistance, and third one, percentage of steel. By using M20 grade of concrete, and Fe 415 steel. So first of all, we have to write here given data. Whatever the given in the statement, that we have to write here. So here they provide the balanced rectangular section. So I will draw here. Balanced rectangular section having dimension B, and this small d is the effective depth of beam. So this is the effective depth, and this is the singly reinforced beam. So I will provide the reinforcement at the tension zone. This is the neutral axis. So in this, they have given M20 grade of concrete. It means that sigma CBC, the permissible stress of concrete due to bending, they have given. So for M20, the value of sigma CBC is given in IS 456 on page number 81 in table number 21 for M20 grade. So sigma CBC is equal to 7 Newton per mm square. Similarly, they have given the Fe415 steel. So sigma ST will be 230 Newton per mm square. So by using this sigma CBC, we can calculate the modular ratio. Is equal to 280 divided by 3 sigma CBC. So 280 divided by 3 into 7. So it will be 13.3. Now we have to calculate the depth of the neutral axis. So I will draw here the stress distribution diagram. This is the balance section. This is sigma ST by M. this is the sigma CBC, this is the depth of neutral axis. So this is the balance section. So x is equal to xc. So first one, depth of neutral axis, depth of neutral axis, x is equal to xc is equal to k into d. So we have to find out the k. So k is nothing but the m sigma cbc divided by m sigma cbc plus sigma st. So the value of m is 13.33, into sigma cbc is 7 newton per mm square, divided by 13.33 into 7 as it is, plus sigma st 230. So after calculating this, we will get the value of k, that is 0.288. So this is the value of k. So we have to put this value into this equation. Therefore x is equal to xc is equal to 0.288 into d. So this is the depth of neutral axis. Now second one, moment of resistance. So moment of resistance MR is equal to Q into BD square. So here Q is the moment of resistance factor, and the formula for moment of resistance factor Q is equal to, that is sigma CBC into K into J divided by 2. So this is the moment resistance factor. So in this we know sigma CBC, we know the K, that is neutral axis coefficient, and this is the lever arm coefficient. So we have to calculate here J. So J is nothing but 1 minus K by 3. So 1 minus, we have calculated already the value of K, that is 0.288 divided by 3. So after calculating this, we will get the value of J, that is 0.904. So we have to put the values of J and K and sigma CBC, that is Q is equal to sigma CBC 7 into K, that is 0.288, into J 0.904 divided by 2. So after calculating this, we will get the value of Q is 0.911. So this is the Q. Now we have to calculate the moment of resistance. So MR is equal to Q, we have calculated the value of Q, that is 0.911, into BD square. So this is the moment of resistance. Now third one, we have to calculate the percentage of steel. percentage of steam, which is denoted by P suffix T. So the formula for percentage of steam, PT, is equal to sigma CVC into K divided by 2 into sigma ST into 100. So this is the formula to calculate the percentage of steam. So in this, sigma CVC we know, neutral axis coefficient we know, sigma ST we know. So just we have to put the values. So PT is equal to sigma CVC 7 into K, that is 0.288, divided by 2 into sigma ST 230 into 100. So PT is equal to 0.438%. So in this way, we have calculated the depth of neutral axis, moment of resistance, and percentage of steam.